You can win $32,000 on the turn of a single card on Card Shark. And if you play your cards right, you can win this beautiful Cadillac Fleetwood sedan. Now, here's the star of Card Sharks, Bill Rafferty.
Oh, yeah. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, Gene Wood. What a man. Thank you, sir. Everybody to Card Sharks, you know, we've just loaded up this game with new prizes. We've got cash, we've got trips, we've got a whole bunch of things going on right now. It's exciting, and there's no reason to waste any time with me jabbering at the top of the show. Let's meet our lovely dealers. Here they come right now. Oh, yeah. Lacey Pemberton and Susanna Williams. Ooh. Ooh. Hot stuff. Ooh, that's nice.
You like it?
Last week was good, but this is good. This is very good. You know, what do we have in the cards today? We've got some prize cards in there. We've got a trip to Alaska.
I believe.
We've got a 40-inch Sony TV or a type, I don't know if it's a Sony TV, but 40-inch widescreen TV.
Yes.
And cash worth $5,000. Oh. I think it's time to deal
out the
cards.
We're ready to give it away.
Go get them, ladies. Let's meet our card sharks. How are you, Susan?
I'm wonderful. How are you?
Nice to have you here.
Thank you.
Tell us a little bit about yourself.
My name is Susie Guidi. I'm from San Diego, California. I'm married. My husband's Gino. I've got 5 children, and I'm a barber in San Diego.
You're a hair cutter.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, now, you said this before the other day. We didn't have enough time to get in it because we introduced you towards the end of the show. But you've got 5 kids?
5 kids.
What are their ages?
I have a 9-year-old, a 5-year-old, a 4-year-old, a 3-year-old, and a 6-month-old.
Ooh. So you...
And I want to have about 5 more.
Yeah, you really are.
No,
I know. No, some people say, hey, it's just another kid, another potato in the pot.
Enough,
who knows?
Enough.
Anyway, well, listen, good luck to you.
Thank you.
Hello, Vern.
Hello, Bill.
Nice to see you.
Well, when I was in San Luis Obispo, I used to have 300 kids.
Oh, you were
a
teacher.
A principal. When I used to teach Spanish, but now I try to spend all the time I can on the golf course.
Oh, you do. You too, huh? I try and get out there a lot, but I'm the worst. Anyway, Vern, that X in front of Vern doesn't mean he's an adulterer. That means he's already won one game, and he's got $100 on his side of the board right now. And we're about ready to start our second game. First player to win 2 games, they win the match. They go on to $32,000 in the money cards if they're lucky. And do not forget right now, we have got a brand new Cadillac waiting. They'll also get a shot at that. A lot of loot available right now. This is a must-win situation for Susie.
For
she's got to tie it up right here so she can get a chance at the money cards. And here is our second game. First question coming up right now, audience polling question. We have... in our audience today, 10 aspiring actors and actresses. Come on up. There they go. Nice to have them with us. Aspiring actors and actresses is kind of another word for starving actors and actresses. They're trying to make a buck here in town, and it is tough. I know that for a fact. Anyway, here's our first question. Goes to Susie. Before the show, we asked these 10 aspiring actors and actresses, do you spend more money on acting lessons than you do on clothes? How many of these 10 actors and actresses do spend more money on acting lessons?
There's 5 men out there and 5 women. Boy, the women I bet definitely do. The men I don't know. Acting lessons are pretty important. And if I was an aspiring actor, I'd want all the lessons I could get. I'd say that 63 of them spend more money.
That's a great number, 63. I like 63. If I were to guess, I probably would say 63. However, do me a favor, keep it 10 or less. Just 10 or less.
You lost me completely.
Humor me.
I was looking at the whole audience. These 10.
These 10 right here.
Okay, six.
Six. That's good. What do you say, Vern?
No, I think they think that clothing makes the person. I'm going to say it's a little bit higher.
Okay, now, do you understand what the deal is here? They're spending more money on acting lessons than clothes.
No, they're going to be lower. More money on clothes.
You're going more money on clothes.
More
so
money
you're
on
saying
clothes.
It is lower. All right. The actual number of these aspiring actors and actresses who spend more money on acting lessons is... 7, so it isn't lower, it's higher.
Yeah!
Higher.
Good cards!
Now, Where are the three who just want to look good when they lose the job? Where are you up there? The three ladies right there, yeah, I could see why, because you just look terrific right now anyway, so it's just a matter of how you show up for it. Anyway, thank you very much. Have a seat. Let's go to the board right now. Here you are, Susan. Tell me what you want to do.
I need, king. Ooh, We're going to go lower. We're going to go lower.
We've got a jack.
We're going to go lower.
We've got a jack. We've got a five.
Oh, my God.
Higher than a five, we've got a six.
Freeze on the six.
Takes the conservative approach. She's gonna freeze on the six. Gets some of the crowd hostile, but you're not up here on the lights, sir. Here we go to our second question. This one goes to Vern. She's gonna freeze there and keep Vern away from the cards. That's a good thing to do. Anyway, let's take a question over here to Vern. Vern, sir, we surveyed 100 bachelors and we asked them, have you ever romanced the wife of one of your buddies behind his back? Well, when you do it in front of them, they get angry. You know, some guys don't know how to hold a relationship together. They get so picky about these things. Anyway, how many bachelors admitted they have romanced their buddy's wife?
I think if they did that, they wouldn't admit it. I think it's going to be a comparatively low number, about 22.
22. What do you say, Susie?
It's going to be a little bit lower. Nobody's going to admit to that.
Nobody's going to admit.
No.
Okay, let's see how many of these sleaze bags there really are. Anyway, the actual number of bachelors who have romanced their buddy's wife is 12. It is. Yeah. There it is, lower.
Change that card.
All right.
Change that card.
Strategy is the key to it here. She's going to change the card.
Two.
A seven. Oh. Right in the middle.
Okay, higher.
If she's right, she ties up the match.
Higher.
If she's wrong, Vern gets a free shot at the cards, and we'll have to see what happens. Higher than a
seven.
It is. We got a tie. Good call. Very tough call. Good call. We'll be back with a tiebreaker right after this. Stick around. We're having some fun now. Welcome back, everybody. Here we are right now. Congratulations to Susie. Susie's won one game. She's got this thing all tied up right now, and there they are. Suzanne and Lacey, they're getting ready to play the tiebreaker. We play that. It's a three-card game, maximum of two questions. And here we go. No reason to waste any time.
Let's get started with it.
Yeah, Susie says,
I'm ready.
This is our educated guess question again.
Wonderful.
This is where you've got to just kind of think about this a little bit. How old is Shirley Temple?
Woohoo, boy. Hey, well, she can't be that old because she was a little girl when I was a little girl. Right, so she can't be too ancient. I'm gonna say she is 63. I love that number.
You like that number? 63. Vern, what do you say, sir? She's a little bit more your contemporary.
Shirley Temple's my contemporary. I'll say just a little bit lower.
A little lower than 63? I thought she was 63 when she was playing in the movies. I don't know. She's a weird little girl to me, I'll tell you that.
I know.
Picky. All right. You're going 63. Vern is going lower. Shirley Temple age is 58. It is lower.
Oh, no!
It is lower. So, Vern, you get a shot at it right now. Here we go. Take a look at the base card, sir. A queen.
Oh, lower.
Lower than a queen? An eight.
Oh, freeze.
Gonna freeze on the eight.
Freeze.
Gonna freezes on the eight. He's right in the middle. We now face sudden death. This is our final question of our tiebreaker. Somebody must win it on this next play of the cards. Control of the board here, most important. Vern made the decision to freeze on the eight. If he gets the question right, he goes back there and changes that card. And it could be the land of parting gifts for Susan.
Oh, no.
Let's see what happens. Vern, psychologist in Glamour magazine recently declared that sex is the single most important part of marriage. So we surveyed 100 married women and we asked them, do you agree? How many married women do agree that sex is the most important part of marriage?
Well, it's way ahead of whatever's in second place, I can tell you that. I think it's going to be about 62.
62. What do you say, Susie?
62 women think that's the most important thing?
Sex is the most important part of marriage.
I think it's going to be lower.
If you're going lower than 62?
Yeah, there's a lot more than just that.
I kind of agree with
Susie.
I know the most important thing in my marriage is my wife's nails this week.
My husband's job.
Okay. The actual number of married women who agree sex is the most important part of a marriage is 16. It is lower.
Come on, Need some good cards.
All right, Susie, you got a decision.
I need some good cards.
You got a decision. We could change your base card, and you can play on, but if you make a mistake, that means that Vern is automatically the winner. Or you could pass control of the board over to Vern.
I gotta go for it.
She's gonna go for it. No use getting into the speech. Let's take a look at the base card. You got a four.
Higher, 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 higher.
Higher than a four. An eight.
Lower, 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 lower.
Lower than an ace for the game and the match. There it is.
I knew you were going to. Good decision.
Good decision. All righty. You want to hit Vern? Stay here for a second. Listen, Vern, you've got $100. We got some party gifts for you. Thank you so much for being here.
Okay.
Thank you, Vern.
Good plan. Good plan. Made the right decision.
We will be right back with Susie. Susie's going to play the money cards. $32,000 there. Brand new Cadillac. Stick around. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everybody. Here we are with Susie. She's our new champ. She wants to win the car. She's going to have an opportunity right now to try and do it. Here is Susanna and Lacey to deal out the money cards. You know how we play it. In addition to all the money you can win, which is $32,000, we have added four jokers to the deck. Anytime one of them turns up in the money cards, you will have a shot at winning this brand new car. Gene?
Contemporary design, advanced technology, and luxury are the hallmarks of the 1986 Cadillac Sedan DeVille. Features front-wheel drive and state-of-the-art electronics furnished by Cadillac. And, Susie, this car can be yours if you play your cards right.
Thank you, Gene. Come on over here, Susie.
Okay.
Little disappointed. Little disappointed with the oohs and the ahs on the car. I'll expect something a little better next time. Anyway, for winning the match now, Susie, we're going to give you an extra joker, which Susanna is showing us right now, which means you definitely have a chance to win
the
car.
Oh, right. That's all I need.
Okay. Let's get Susie started right now. $200, please. There it is. Come on, Susie, make some money.
Okay, okay.
Here's the base card. You got a queen.
$150 lower.
$150 lower than a queen. We've got a four.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
$350 on the queen.
Okay, $300
higher. $300 higher than a four. A seven.
Oh,
$650.
I'm going to change.
Tell me which one you want.
Number two.
All righty. That seven now becomes a nine.
Oh.
$650 on a nine.
I'm going to say $100 higher.
$100
higher,
$100 higher than a nine. It's a five.
Oh, good.
$550. We bring you up to the second level, give you an additional $400.
I'm going to change that card.
$950.
Okay. I'm going to change that card.
Change that card?
Number one.
A new one. All right. Let's take a card here and look at it. We've got a seven.
Oh.
$950 on a seven.
Okay. $100 lower.
$100
lower. Lower.
Right in the middle. You can go either way with this. $100 lower than a seven. It's a three.
$1,000 higher. $1,000 higher. Higher.
$1,000 higher than a three. An eight.
Everything lower.
$2,050 lower. It is. $4,100. Take a breath. $4,100. You have a king. You must wager at least half.
$2,050. I want $4,000 lower.
$4,000 lower.
Yes!
It's $8,000 on the turn of a card.
Be there, be there, be there.
$4,000 lower. It is. $8,100.
Thank you.
There, we're not done. Thank you, Susanna. You have one joker right now, which means you will have one opportunity to try and find the car. There are seven numbered cards over there behind. One of them is the word car. You find the word car, you're going to drive out of here in a Cadillac. Go put your joker wherever you want.
I'm doing this for my three-year-old daughter. It's got to be lucky.
It's got to be lucky. If the word car is here, it's all yours. Car! Terrific. She came out to win the car.
Oh, my gosh.
We've got cash and prizes totaling $31,699. You did it. You did it. You... Nobody's calmed down yet. The whole studio is in absolute turmoil. You know, when you put it there, it was a 7-to-1 shot, number one, that you were going to get it. And when you put it there, there's a young lady offstage, Sean, who tells me where the actual car, and she just went, ah, and we went crazy. I knew you had it. And there it was. You have just won $31,699 cash and prizes. That's a car. Terrific.
Yeah,
terrific.
Thank you.
Good for you.
Oh, my God.
Okay, come on out. Here's Larry. Let's go. Come on, Larry. Here's the challenge. Larry, introduce yourself, please.
I'm Larry Levy. I'm originally from San Francisco, and I'm a sales representative for a car dealer.
Oh, originally from San Francisco?
Yes.
That's in my neck of the woods. I live up in Northern California. Nice to have you here.
Thank you. You've
already cut your cards backstage?
Yes, I have.
I want to let you know, sir, that we've got the prize cards in there. We have got a trip to Austria, a washer and dryer. And don't forget, there's a card in there worth $5,000. A lot to play for. Here we go with our first question again. Our audience polling question, and here come our 10 aspiring actors and actresses. Terrific. Here we go. Susie, this first question is for you. Before the show, we ask these 10 actors and actresses, if you were offered a starring role in a movie, but the plot required you to do a nude scene, would you do it? How many of these 10 aspiring actors and actresses would be willing to do a nude scene?
Well, only one of those girls out there is blushing right now, so the number's going to be pretty high. I think to get started in this kind of business, you got to do a few things that, you know, are a little bit off-colored. Definitely, eight out of these 10 actors and actors down here would do it. They'd go for it.
Larry, what do you think, higher or lower?
I don't think they'd all want to bear all. I think it's going to be a little bit lower.
You're going a little bit lower than eight?
A little lower.
The actual number of these aspiring actors and actresses who would do a nude scene is 7. It is lower.
Oh.
It is lower by 1.
Oh.
Who are the 7 who are sacrificing all for their career?
Yes.
Would you raise your hand?
Yeah, 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 yeah,
yeah. I don't mean to be picky, but the gentleman on the end with the bald head, you think that this would move your career along, sir?
Well, first off, I don't think I'd get a chance like that. So I don't worry about it.
Well, we could do it right now. Come on up here. Let's go. Thank you very much. Have a seat. Thank you. All right, Larry, take a look here, sir. Here's your base card. Tell me what you want to do. You got a jack. Good.
Beautiful card. Let's go lower.
Lower than a jack. We've got a 6.
I'm going to freeze.
Freeze on a six. Freezes on a 6. Conservative gentleman. He's going to get this next question. If he gets it right, he changes it, and we'll see what happens then. Second question goes to Larry. We surveyed 100 top business executives, and we asked them, if your company were in danger of going broke, would you work for free for a year to help your company get back on its feet again? How... oh, yeah. How many top business executives said they would work for free for a year?
The theory sounds great, but the practicality certainly doesn't. I definitely would never work for free for anyone. I think it's going to be a low number. I would say it's going to be 26.
26. Higher or lower?
It's definitely going to be lower. That's a real fairy tale kind of statement. It's going to be lower.
You're going lower.
Lower.
You're going lower.
Definitely lower.
The actual number of top business executives who would work for free for a year is 82. It is not lower, it's higher.
Oh.
A lot of company men out there.
Change that card, please.
You watch to change it. Let's take a look at it right now. It's a 9.
Let's just play with the card. Let's go higher.
Gonna go higher.
I'm going to go higher.
A little bit against the odds there, you know. A little against the odds. He's going higher than a 9. He's got a 4. So, we didn't do it. He went against the odds and paid the price. Free shot for Susie.
All right, come
on. Susie. Got a 9.
Oh, I'm going to go lower. Let's go lower. Lower.
Lower than a 9. A 3.
Yeah, let's go higher.
Higher than a 3. A juice.
Oh,
only one card could beat you, and that was it. We are going to be right back with Sudden Death right after this. Here's Lacey. We'll be back tomorrow with Sudden Death. We'll see you then. Bye-bye.
Essentially, we're asking you to play God.
On the next, Without Prejudice.
I think it looks like white trash.
Oh, I'm going to pull the race card.
Can a panel of ordinary people judge 5 strangers without prejudice? Could you?
There are people who attract convicts.
She married a guy who killed 3 people.
That's just who she loved. You can't help who she loves.
You're quick to formulate opinions. You're a little biased.
It's the provocative new series, Without Prejudice, tonight at 8, 7 Central on GSN.
This is the battle